All right, guys, I'm back out here today. I was out here a little bit earlier. I got this culvert pipe laid in here. I did have to straighten out a few spots with the shovel, just some couple little high spots and whatnot. And I got that all situated, so we got a nice even slope going all the way down now. I test fitted the pipe. I checked it with a level, made sure it was all good, and we got a continuous slope going down here. I threw some tape on the spots where I had the couplers, so where I had the adapter here. I use some Gorilla tape just to kind of keep it together because the couplers don't hold it really tight. So I always advise to throw some tape around just to keep it a little bit stronger together. So I got that. And then there's one more coupler down this way right here. So that one's taped as well. So got it all dug out over here. Made a little pathway for it to drain out. And so now what we're going to be doing is I got my buddy Matt here with me. He's going to be holding the pipe down with his foot. We're going to start on one end. And I'm just gonna start backfilling it, and we'll just kind of work our way down. I'm not worried about getting every little bit of it right now. I just kind of want to tie the pipe down. So as he puts his foot on it and I kind of back drag some and we get enough to hold it down, we'll probably continue to move on. And then we'll work our way all the way down to the end here. And once I get down to the very end, I gotta, it's gonna be a little bit tricky because I'm probably gonna have to move some of this topsoil here so I can get the tractor in here to try to get some of this back. Because if you guys notice, my drainage pipes are right here and that bank actually came straight over here. So I have all this on the wrong side right now because of where I had to dump it. So I'm probably gonna have to use the loader bucket and scoop this up and put it over here so I can get my tractor in here to get this last little bit out of here. And then once I get that out of there, I'll be able to spread it back out here and rebuild this berm that goes across like this. Either that or I'm gonna have to do it all with a shovel. And I'd much rather use the tractor if I could. So, I guess we'll get to work here. Matt, you got your feet ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Instead of this big hump, dude. Always hated the way that
corrugated pipe's pretty strong shit, you know? Yeah. I mean, even though this is like one ply, I could stand on it.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you get a little dirt on top, it actually beefs it right up.
Yeah.
Most of it filled back in, turning out pretty nice. Now we got to get into this section over here where this berm was at, and as I explained before, I'm gonna have to come over on this side. Now that I got it filled in, I can cross over, and I'm gonna scoop all this out, make a pile over here somewhere, kind of where Matt's standing behind him, and then I can start rebuilding this berm here. And whatever I have left over from the pile that I make over here, I'll use that in all the low spots. All right, well, we got the berm, got that all made up. Looks really nice. It's about in the exact same spot it was in last time. Water can round the edges and go over there. There's the pipe. I got some rocks I'm gonna put up and around the pipe. Turned out nice. So yeah, now I'm just gonna level this off, and I'll take the loader bucket and I'll skim it and get this graded out or as flat as I can just with the bucket. It ain't got to be perfect tonight because we're supposed to get like a monsoon tomorrow, I guess. Lots of rain, high winds, so I know this is all going to settle again anyway, so I'm not going to try to get it perfect here tonight. I just want to get it so that it's presentable, looks decent. And then after we get this rain, I'll probably make another video spreading that topsoil over there from the alleyway. I'll probably use that and I'll spread it out because that's a little bit nicer stuff. And then I'll spread that out over top of this and then maybe even throw some seed down before the weather starts to get too cold. So Matt's gonna be my cameraman again, and we'll get to it. Cameraman zoning out. All right, well, this is such a dip in here that, you know, this is about as good as I can get it with the tractor, just because it's dipped this way, that way, about every way you can imagine. So I'm gonna rake the rest of this out. Let's rake this real quick, but you guys get the general picture. It looks pretty good. Drove over it a lot, got it nice and packed in. Yep, it's gonna rain tomorrow, so it'll pack the rest of it in. So I'm just gonna go over this real quick with a rake, and that's gonna be about it. I'll let the rain hit tomorrow, and then you know, someday later in this week when it warms up again or when the sun comes back out, I will make another video using that topsoil there, which is actually some pretty nice stuff, and I'll use that to kind of do a top coat on this and make it look real pretty. But it actually doesn't look too bad for the type of dirt that was in here. It actually turned out pretty nice, just doing a quick job with the tractor. So that's gonna be it for this one, guys. I appreciate you watching. And as always, we'll see you guys in the next one.